How many are from four? I am from threes.
We have two from threes, from twos. 1, 2, 3, and then we have from one, obvious. Now, she is going to lead us in a song. It is, I think, a song that we know. So you keep the mic. See, my many party, you must go and see. Where? Wapangi is your mic. Ah, you see what? You see what I give you? Ah, you want to move? See my? And then you go put it. Now I pay a rusa. See my many go put it. And then you do your music. Now we just get home. We keep the church. We just get more church. Yeah.
Bariki, mi, 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 m
God bless you. Thank you. God bless you. Amen. Give them another cup of offering, please. Amen. Okay. Acts chapter 10. I was there last Sunday, but I got to go back. Let's read it again, very brief, from verse number 1, very fast, if you can, 1, 2, 3. And Caesarea, there was a man named Cornelius, a centurion in what was known as the Italian regiment. Continue. He and his family were devout, God-fearing. He gave generously to those in need and prayed to God regularly. Verse number 3. One day at about 3 in the afternoon, we are in verse 3. One day at about 3 in the afternoon, he had a vision. He distinctly saw an angel of God who came to him and said, Cornelio. Cornelius stared at him in fear. What is it, Lord? He asked. The angel answered, your prayer and gifts to the poor have come as a memorial offering before God. Amen. I shared on 4 things that will make God to remember you. 4 things you cannot write off. If you do those 4 things, it will change your life and your destiny forever. And it happened to this young man, this commander of the army called Cornelius. He was in Caesarea
Philippi.
I believe he came to know Jesus when Jesus had visited that place many years
earlier.
Because they were the Gentiles. You remember Jesus going to Caesarea Philippi and asking people, who do people say that I am? I believe he was in that meeting where Peter said, you are the Christ, the Son of the living God. And this man believed in Jesus. And it was Jesus went, he continued in a lifestyle. He went in a lifestyle. This was his lifestyle. Number one, the Bible says he was devoted to God. Number two, he prayed regularly. Number three, he was God-fearing. And number four, he gave regularly. He was a giver. And I looked at this in the essence of connecting the fear of God and worship and giving together. The word devout means he was a worshiper. Number two, he feared God. When you fear God, you want to obey him. When you fear God, you want to do his word. When you fear God, you take things of God seriously. Amen.
Amen.
Number three, he prayed. He was a prayerful person. And number four, he was a giver. Now what amazes me is this. When the Lord remembered him, he sends Peter. And for the first time, the gospel to go out of Jerusalem. It went to the house of God.
Yes.
He was the first person among the people of the heathen to be remembered by God and for the gospel to go to another nation. So he said your prayers and your gifts have become as a memorial offering before God. And everybody hear me as I say this. There are things that will make God always to remember you. Including when you are in difficulty, God will remember you. When you cry to him, he will remember you. When the enemy has attacked you, God will remember you. And one of the key things that God will cause you to be remembered is what gives. Please get it from you. You are giving. Giving is to God.
It's
one of the most powerful tools that God makes God to remember people. Amen. In fact, it says in another one, your giving has come as a remembrance to God, as a memorial sacrifice. What you have been doing has been remembered as a sacrifice, as a memorial.
kitu cha kumbukumbu.
Hear me.
Nisikie.
In this country,
katika
taifa hili, there are days we remember.
Kuna siku tunazozikumbuka.
Like Kenyatta Day.
Kama Kenyatta Day.
Like Madaraka Day.
Madaraka Day.
Like Moi Day. Moi Day is no longer there.
Jadi.
We have Moi Day. We also have Moi Day.
Jaji na Odunga alirudisha.
And it is a good day.
Ana siku nzuri.
Bwana asifiwe. How many are with me? Bwana asifiwe. In most days,
katika siku hizo,
we remember Christmas.
Tunakumbuka
Christmas. It is a season of remembrance.
Ni majira ya kukumbuka.
The things that happened.
Mambo yaliyofanyika.
Amen.
Amen.
How many are with me? Blessed be the name of the Lord. Now I want you to imagine.
Ningependa uweze kufikiria.
You giving in the house of God, giving to the needy. And you are giving becomes a memorial.
Kunafanyika kumbukumbu.
You know there are people who like to do memorial services for their people who died.
Kuna watu wanapenda kufanya maibada ya ukumbusho kwa watu wao waliokufa.
That you know we are going home, we are having a memorial service. Kunakwenda kuwakelea msalaba.
Kuwakelea msalaba.
Kuna maombi.